Patriot Viper Venom DDR5 RAM. Let's take a look. 64 gigabytes over two sticks. It's a simple lower cost kit, but it has a lot of the features and functionality that just make it very easy to use. I'm going to be focusing on AMD 9000 series CPUs and all the configuration related to that. Obviously, these should work fine with Intel or older AMD options. Make sure which slots you should populate first on your motherboard and your configuration. You want to have them in the right slots so they function properly. Generally, with this specific series of AMD CPUs and motherboards, you're going to most likely want to only have two sticks of RAM, because if you have four sticks, you're probably going to have to lower the speeds on it. So these rated speeds on the RAM might not necessarily work properly with four sticks. So keep that in mind if you do try to go with four sticks of RAM. Once it is installed, go into your motherboard BIOS and enable the AMD Expo settings. Obviously, if you have Intel, do the XMP. In my specific motherboard, I could use either one, but it makes the most sense to use the AMD Expo settings. The important specifications of this RAM: 5600 megatransfers per second, CL40. With the AMD Expo settings enabled, the voltage is around 1.35 volts, actually a little bit under that in my case. And then there is also a VPP voltage, which is 1.8 volts. The cast latency for this RAM is 40, 40, 40, 76. There are a huge amount of settings in my specific motherboard for this RAM that you could see on screen. Look at those and verify anything that you need to know. We've got the main timing settings, we have the sub timing settings, a turnaround timing configuration, and miscellaneous. I specifically bought RAM that didn't have RGB, but I would say the overall look of this RAM isn't anything exciting. I would have preferred just straight black without any other colors on it, but it's fine. They have heat spreaders. They do the job. After getting the computer set up, I did run memtest 86 on this RAM and it verified okay, it's functional. Haven't had any issues with it as far as I can tell. If you're trying to be more budget conscious, yet also considering you want more RAM for whatever reason. In my case, I do a lot of creative things, photo editing, video editing. I'd prefer more RAM that is of a reasonable speed rather than very fast, small amount of RAM. This RAM isn't anything special, but it functions, it works, it was easy to configure, no complaints. Let's look at the Patriot Viper Gaming Venom DDR5, in this case 5600 megatransfer, CL40 at 64 gigabytes for the kit. It's kind of tech, I suppose. See ya.